So let's talk about how to inspect tracks and undercarriage for internal wear. Sometimes this measurement is referred to as track pitch. As you know, the pins and bushings have internal wear that will occur between them. As that track travels around and flexes, these will move back and forth over time, causing internal wear and an increase in these internal clearances. Now, some types of tracks, such as sealed and lubricated track, known as salt track, can greatly reduce this internal wear, but it will still happen. As this occurs over time, here we have two sections of track, a pin on this side, bushing on this one, and you can see that there's clearance between them. As this occurs, that will allow that track to elongate, or sometimes they call it stretch, and the track pitch becomes longer. So this is an important measurement for technicians to perform to check for internal pin and bushing wear. Now, when you do this, because it is a small clearance that we're looking for, most manufacturers, like John Deere for this machine, recommends checking the track pitch across several lengths. In this case, you can see in our picture, they want to check it across four lengths, or what I like to say is we're measuring to the fifth pin. They will provide specifications for that. This is the chart for this 450H machine. And it goes anywhere from 0% to 100%, even to 120% wear that we can see. So we're going to measure that track pitch and compare it to our specifications. Before we can measure track pitch, however, you can see the track is in its normal relaxed position. We need that track pulled tight. Just like I did with those pieces in my hand, you need to pull it tight to get the overall dimension of it. The best way to do that is going to be by using a metal pin, we have here just a large bucket pin or a piece of round stock. We're going to put that in the sprocket and back the machine up until this track is then stretched tight, and then we can proceed with measuring our pitch. So now you can see our pin. As that track stretched tight, we have no clearance in there. Now it is important, we want to make sure that when we're measuring this, we are not measuring across the master link. On these track chains, one link will look different than the others. On some cases, on your sealed track, the master link will often have a dimple or center point mark in the center of the pin, indicating that's the pin you would want to drive out. In this case, we're dealing with salt tracks, and our master link is right down at the bottom here. You can see that's a solid link. It doesn't have the openings that all the other links have. So that's down the bottom. We don't need to worry about it. We're in good shape. We're going to use this tape measure provided from CAT. The part number is 5P3277, and it's a little different than a regular tape measure in that it doesn't measure in fractional inches. It has a millimeter side, which can be handy, and the inch side measures in tenths or even smaller, basically 2/100ths of an inch. So it allows us to get a decimal reading with a tape measure rather than a fractional reading, because we are looking for a small difference. In that picture I held up, it may have looked like they were measuring from center of pin, but that would be hard for you to determine and hold the tape measure out reliably. So we're going to hold it at the edge of the pin, a clear defined edge, and we will go across four lengths, but we'll basically be measuring to the fifth pin. So I'm gonna hook this here. That's one here, two, three, four, five. We're measuring to this point here. In inches, it looks like I'm just under, let me move my hand out of the way so you can see, I'm just under 25.2. In millimeter side, and it's a good practice to use a light to read this clearly, it looks like I'm at exactly 639 millimeters. And when we compare that measurement to the specifications, we'll see that 639 millimeters or 25.2, this indicates this is exactly 0% worn. So this is relatively new track, has a lot of life left in it. Remember, when you're finished, you will need to remove the pin to return the track to its normal state. And it's a good practice to recheck your track sag adjustment after performing this. If your track pitch is found to be excessive, One option for repair would be to turn the pins and bushings. This is a common practice that will allow basically 50% again life, or even 100% of life to get that out of the tracks. What that involves is taking the tracks off the machine, and every pin and bushing will be removed and turned 180 degrees. That is not going to fix the amount of wear, that clearance is still in there, but it's now going to put an unworn spot against another unworn spot and basically restore our track pitch, allowing that track to get longer service life. If the pins and bushings have already been turned and now our track pitch is excessive, the only option is for a new track chain to be installed.